Hello, my name is Christopher Robinson, and I am a junior at the University of Delaware studying sport management. My obscure but phenomenal moment in African American history is the Rosewood Massacre of 1923. And I will be doing a skit slash spoken word to highlight the injustices and wrongdoings against Black people throughout U.S. history. Thank you for your time and enjoy.
Yeah, man, it's like that's super crazy. Like, it's so crazy to me. Like, Black people are like the most resilient people I know. Like, we've been through so much, so many trials and tribulations over the year. Like, it's crazy. Like, just to name a few, like, slavery lasted about 250 years. Segregation in itself lasted about 100 years. So, like, even the first Black official was elected official wasn't elected till, like, 1870. And that was during the Jim Crow era. So, like, you feel me? Like, this, Black people go through a lot of different stuff.
Why do Black people always complain about that stuff? It's like you're living in the past. You haven't personally lived through it. It's not like you can go back and change history. It already happened. It's over. Get over it.
Let me call you back.
Get over it? Get over it. Correct me if I'm wrong, but you said get over it? That's funny. Like, you're actually hilarious. Like, you do realize that all those things happened in the past still have an effect on our community today. Other communities like the Native Americans and Asian Americans have received reparations, and Black people haven't received a single thing. You see, the Native Americans had the Native American Graves Protection and Reparations Act in 1990, and then the Asian Americans, they had the Civil Liberty Act of 1988. See, Black people haven't received any type of, you know, reparations for the injustices that were done to them in this country, but for slavery, they're like, there's nothing to show for it, like nothing at all. Black people have received nothing, and everything was set up against Blacks since the first day they were shipped here in 1619. Not to mention that we have been technically free to do what we want for only 56 years because of the Civil Rights Act of 1964, which ended segregation. I'd also like to mention the fact that there has been many wrongful attacks, punishments, and deaths against Black people all throughout U.S. history. Names like Trayvon Martin, Emmett Till, and Eric Garner should ring a bell. And don't even get me started on the Central Park 5. There has been an assortment of massacres against Black communities as well. One of the most significant ones is the Rosewood Massacre in 1923. You see, Rosewood, it was a predominantly African-American town in Florida that was doing well until a white woman in the town of Sumner got assaulted by a white man, but she lied about it and said it was a Black man that assaulted her. This caused a huge amount of whites in the area to riot, and they eventually ended up destroying the town of Rosewood, burning buildings, looting stores, and killing innocent Black people. There was a reported 20 Black people dead, but who knows, it could have been way more. Survivors from the massacre didn't receive any sort of compensation for the massacre until 1995, and Florida's consideration of the bill to compensate the victims of racial violence was the first by any U.S. state. There was another race riot in Atlanta in 1906. You see, after the Civil War ended, Black people started elevating, establishing businesses, and getting into politics. As Blacks gained more rights and status, tension between white people and Black people grew. Hoke Smith was a former publisher of the Atlanta Journal, and Clark Howe was the editor of the Atlanta Constitution. Both candidates used their influence to incite white voters and help spread fear that whites may not be able to maintain the current social order. The Atlanta Georgian and the Atlanta News began publishing stories about white women being molested and raped by Black men. These allegations were reported multiple times and were straight up false. On September 22, 1906, Atlanta newspapers reported 4 alleged assaults on local white women. Soon after, some 10,000 white men and boys began gathering, beating and stabbing Blacks. It is estimated that there was between 25 and 40 African-American deaths, and it was confirmed that there were only 2 white deaths out of the whole situation. Another situation where Black people were brutally mistreated is the Chicago race riots. The Red Summer of 1919 marked the climax of steadily growing racial tensions surrounding the great migration of African Americans from the rural South to the booming cities in the North during World War I. Chicago was one of the northern cities that experienced violent race riots during that period. Drawn by the city's meatpacking houses, railway companies, and steel mills, the African-American population in Chicago skyrocketed from 44,000 in 1910 to 235,000 in 1930. When the war ended in late 1918, thousands of white servicemen returned home from fighting in Europe to find that their jobs in factories, warehouses, and mills had been filled by newly arrived Southern Blacks or immigrants. On July 27, 1919, an African-American teenager drowned in Lake Michigan after he challenged the unofficial segregation of Chicago's beaches and was stoned to death by a group of white kids. His death and police refusal to arrest the men who caused it sparked a week of race rioting between blacks and white Chicagoans, with black neighborhoods receiving the worst of the damage. When the riots ended on August 3rd, 15 whites and 23 blacks had been killed and more than 500 people were injured. An additional 1,000 black families had lost their homes when they were torched by rioters. President Woodrow Wilson castigated white people as the aggressor in the situation. Look, I could go on and on, but you get my point. Stuff like this has been happening for a long time, and black people haven't gotten compensated. Stuff like this has set us black people back, and people today are still affected because we are still not on equal ground with white people.
Wow, sorry, I didn't realize, Chris.
Nah, it's cool. Just educate yourself.